Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Amit. I am working as an assistant professor in chemistry at Government College, Daman. So today we are going to discuss TYBSE Semester 5 Industrial Chemistry Paper 9. And today's topic is manufacture and uses of acrylonitrile using Sohio's method. So in this method, acrylonitrile is prepared from propylene. So actually this method is two step reaction. First step is oxidation, that is air oxidation, and second step is ammonolysis. The name of this method came from the name of scientist named Sohio. So here is the propylene. See, propane means 1, 2, 3 carbons and one double bond, that means propylene, or you can even say propene. On oxidation, it yields acrylamide. Now if you see here, the changes occurs at CH3 to CHO, that means addition, one oxygen is added, so it is oxidation reaction, conversion of this CH3 into this CHO. This two carbon remains as it is, and the final step is ammonolysis in presence of ammonia to form this acrylonitrile. Friends, if you closely see, the changes occurs at this position only, CH3 to CHO and CHO to CN, that is nitrile, acrylonitrile, 3 carbon, 1 CN group. So reaction condition is actually you have to maintain the temperature between 400 to 500 degrees centigrade and pressure between 1.5 to 3 atmosphere. And the uses are, it is useful in the manufacturing of synthetic fibers, rubbers, and plastic. So let's move on to the flowchart portion, in which propylene, ammonia, and air oxygen react together into the catalytic reactor in presence of steam, followed by a water scrubbing with water, and finally absorption and splitting of the byproduct acetonitrile. Here it is the byproduct of this reaction, removed, and finally the crude acrylonitrile get purified by column distillation. Here you will get the pure acrylonitrile. So moving towards the application portion. First is PAN, P-A-N, polyacrylonitrile. Simple, polyacrylonitrile can be prepared by polymerization of acrylonitrile. N numbers of different monomers of acrylonitrile react together for polymerization to form this polyacrylonitrile. This double bond will be removed and CH2, CHCN, N times. This is the repeating unit in this polymer. And what are the uses of this compound? Fibers of polyacrylonitrile have been used in hot gas filtration system. It is used in hot gas filtration system. Second one is dienyl fibers. They are also known as acrylonitrile vinyl chloride copolymer. So acrylonitrile, again n moles of acrylonitrile react with n moles of vinyl chloride. This is vinyl chloride. If you see the structure of acrylonitrile and vinyl chloride, the change is between Cl and Cn. This is vinyl chloride and this is acrylonitrile, right? Polymerization takes place to form this copolymer. If you closely see, this double bond will shift between these two carbons, right? These two carbons. So CH2, again CHCn, and there is a bond between this CH2 and this CH again, and finally CHCl, and another bond. This is the repeating unit, and this compound is known as acrylonitrile vinyl chloride copolymer, or also known as dienyl fibers. And what are the uses? It is used in fiber reinforced plastic composite materials. Next application is NBR, very important, nitrile butadiene rubber. It is also a copolymer. So again, it is reacted with acrylonitrile, react with this 1,3-butadiene. How it is butadiene? There are two double bonds for diene, right? And both are present at 1,3 position. This is 1, 2 and 3. So it is 1,3-butadiene react with acrylonitrile. Polymerization takes place to form this copolymer called NBR, nitrile butadiene rubber. Again, this double bond migrates here, okay? So CH2, CH double bond CH, again CH2, and this double bond migrates between this CH and this CN. So CH2, CHCN and this CH2. So it is known as NBR. And what are the uses? It is used in fuel tank, gasoline pipe, and it can be useful as adhesive as well. Final application is HMDA, hexamethylene diamine. Here, acrylonitrile, 2 moles of acrylonitrile react with hydrogen. This is the hydrogenation reaction, or you can say reduction reaction, to form this adiponitrile. Here there are total 1, 2, 3, 4 CH2 are present, and again reduction takes place to form this hexamethylene diamine. Now hexamethylene, why it is called hexamethylene? There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. 6 number of CH2 methylene groups are there. So it is hexamethylene, and how many NH2 are there? 1 and 2. 2 NH2 are there. So hexamethylene diamine. What are the uses? The main use of HMDA is for the preparation of nylon 6-6. So this is the end of today's lecture. So today we have studied the manufacturing and uses of acrylonitrile, their flowchart, application. Thank you.